Hi, my name is Jay Vandeventer. I'm from Bristol, Tennessee. I'm a junior.
And I'm Marshall Talkington, sophomore from Bristol, Tennessee. You're on the team.
All right, today we're here. We're here today to talk to you guys about some shots around the greens. You know, you got that 150-yard shot from the fairway on your second shot, and you miss the green, and you your first thought is, how am I going to get this up and down for par? There's many ways that you can get up and down for par, and today we're going to talk. Marshall and I are going to talk to you about a couple different ways on how to get the ball up and down. And the fun thing about golf is you can hit many different shots, whatever you feel comfortable with. But today, Marsh and I are going to show you two fairly easy ways to get up and down for par or birdie on a par five. So where the bump and run shot is most important is when you're just off the green and you have a pin that's further on the green. You have a lot of space to work with. All right, so mainly what you're trying to focus on doing is when you have a steep bank that comes down here and you're in the bottom of a bank and you have a pin that's maybe 10, 15 feet on the green where you visually see that you don't have much green to work with. The typical player might pull out a lob wedge and try to get it close, and that's not what you want to do. Some shots that help that have helped me that I've been practicing lately is the bump and run shot. And the most important thing you want to do is you want to have the ball back in your stance to start the bump and run shot. Choke down on the club. You want to have most of your weight on the left side, and you want to really focus on having this wrist, you know, not break down or cock on the way back. You want to keep it really stiff. That way you can bump it up the hill. It almost guarantees you that you're going to get the ball up on the green to where you have a chance for par. Whereas most flop shots around the green to a tight pin or a far pin, you know, can be a little difficult.
And now it's my turn to show the other option around the greens, the flop shot. One good drill when you're working on your flop shots is to practice hitting over things, such as your friend. When you're faced with a short side shot out on the golf course, you've got a bunch of different options. I'm going to show you how to use your lob wedge in a couple different ways. One will be a flop shot and one will be a low little spinner. First, I'm going to show you how to hit the flop shot. The main thing when you're hitting a flop shot is you want to stay loose and you really want to commit to the shot, or else it's not going to come off how you want it to. First, you'll start setting up. You're going to get a little bit open to the target, and the ball position is going to be a little bit up in your stance. And you're going to lay the club face open. Another way to help make sure you get the ball up in the air is to take your grip and weaken it a little bit. So that's going to be, you're going to move your right hand over a little left and your left hand over a little left as well. Once you've got the club face open and your grip is a little bit weak, you're going to take the club back and make sure you keep the club face open by rolling it open with your wrists, kind of like this. And by opening that, it's gonna make it a lot easier for good contact, because when you come through, you're gonna use the bounce of the club, which is the bottom part of it, and it should keep you from chunking it. So you'll take it back, roll the wrist, and you also wanna get a little hinge. The hinge will help you slide it under and get a little more spin, so kind of like this. And then when you're going through, you want to make sure you keep speed. The mid-flight shot is just like the flop shot, except for you're going to have it a little bit further back in your stance, and you're not going to have the club face as wide open. So it'll be more in the middle part of the stance with the club face just a touch open. I use three wedges, the TaylorMade interchangeable, 60, 56, and 52.
I got the new wedges, TaylorMade ATV wedges. Just got these this season. Really like these.
And then probably my favorite club is my putter, which is a Scotty Cameron Newport 1.5.
Favorite club in the bag is probably the driver. Got the R11S, brand new driver from TaylorMade. It's a really, really good driver. Got a couple more yards added onto my distance.
To wrap it up, now that you know how to hit both shots around the green, the bump and run and the flop shot, you can still save par even if you short side yourself. You've been on a tee with the Tennessee Golf Team.